Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Bismillah. Alhamdulillahi wahdah. Wassalatu wassalamu ala man la nabiyya ba'dah. Amma ba'd. Fa'a'udhu billahi s-sami'i al-alimi min ash-shaytani al-rajimi min nafkhihi wa nafthihi wa hamzih. قال الله تعالى في القرآن الكريم في بيوت أذن الله أن ترفع ويذكر فيها اسمه يسبح له فيها بالغدو والآصال. My brothers and sisters, I am coming to you with a very important and critical announcement. And to do that announcement, I really wanted to recite this ayah of the Quran that I chose for you tonight, just to remind us that what we are about to miss. He says in Surah Nur of the Quran, Surah An-Nur, Juz 18 of the Quran, Surah number, I believe it's 24. He says, in these homes, in these houses, which are mosques, which Allah ordered to be built, and that His name be mentioned in them, glorifying, praising Him in the mornings and evenings. My brothers and sisters, I have no doubt that all Masajid of Islam, and especially our Masjid KIC, is one of them, inshallah ta'ala. My brothers and sisters, I do not know a single time in last 20 years, and ask those people who have been here in this town for 50 plus years, those who have set the foundations of this Masjid, and they have lived and seen this Masjid thrive, grow, and flourish, alhamdulillah, longer than we have lived. My brothers and sisters, through all those times, through thick and thin, 9/11 happened. There have been many crises in this country, but alhamdulillah, our masjid for 5 daily prayers, for Jumu'ah, for Ramadan, for Eidain, for I'tikaf, has always been open, not just for Muslims, but also for everybody else that lives in this community and even greater community. This masjid has served not only our local people, but recently in last 3 or 4 years, due to this, mashallah, development of Muslim technologies to locate masajid, many travelers find our masjid at a very beautiful location. My brothers and sisters, every one of us is going through a time that no Muslim has faced in their lives ever, in most difficult times ever, at least in our lifetime, at least in this century. That this masjid, because of the latest lockdown announcement by the governor of state of Michigan, we will have to close the masjid. Yes, tonight after Isha, masjid will be closing. Yes, but inshallah, I have no doubt that masjid will open again. Inshallah, as it is, as of now, it's going to be April 13th. But inshallah, I hope that things will ease up and we will open sooner, inshallah ta'ala. As you know, my brothers and sisters, our tawakkul, our trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, did not allow us to stop going to masjid when government told us to not do so, you know. Our government did not do that. So why should we do that? If non-Muslims are allowing churches and synagogues and temples to remain open, then masjid, our masjid, at least in our county, at least in our state, had to be open. So all those brothers and sisters who were asking for a closure too soon, my brothers and sisters, think about it, that what a blessing was going away from us. I don't know if you know this or not, but ask those who do go to masjid, who do pray in it, that what are they about to miss? But inshallah ta'ala, we know that there is a message in it from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for those who come and for those who don't come. For everyone, there is a message, because this masjid lives here, right here in our hearts, my brothers and sisters. Our masjid is very dear to us. It is very special to us. Regardless of the status of our iman, we love it because it's a house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because we love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I know, my brothers and sisters, that there is a message in it. For those who are masjid goers and those who don't go to masjid, that nothing happens without the permission of Allah. If Allah did not will it, it will not happen. It will not close down. It is closing today, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is taking away the tawfiq from us. Yes, we have the abilities, capabilities, physical strength, and some of us may have, inshallah, the strength of iman also to come. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not allowing us. It is called idhn of Allah, permission of Allah, tawfiq of Allah. My brothers and sisters, in the hustle and bustle of life, we get used to things as we want. We go to work as we plan. We come home as we plan. We plan our events, our weddings, celebrations, you name it. But there are times when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will put a stop to all of this to teach us one thing, that He is Rabbul Alameen. He is the manager of all things. He is the real seer and caretaker of all things. Nothing moves, even a leaf, without the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the message for us. For now, my brothers and sisters, I humbly request you that this is the time to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to not anger Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by staying home and start doing parties and fun gatherings and all kinds of haram stuff, illicit stuff, watching movies and songs and music and all that. No, 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 my brothers, this is not the time for that. This is the time to offer Salatul Ayat, a very special prayer. Inshallah, I'll be talking about it soon. This is the time to make your homes, اجعلوا بيوتكم قبلة, like Allah says in the Quran. Make your homes facing Qibla and establish Salah in them and give good news to the believers. Yes, that's the news, my brothers and sisters, I'm offering here to you. My brothers and sisters, please make sure you do call prayer, a call to Salah. Yes, give Adhan in your homes for 5 times. Even if you're praying alone, you do call Adhan and you do give, you say Iqama. Inshallah, if nobody is there to pray with you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send an army of angels, inshallah, to pray behind you. And maybe good jinn will also join you and pray with you. But angels for sure. If you are in a hurry, you call just the Iqama. 4 angels, according to authentic ahadith, will come and join and pray behind you. If you call Adhan and Iqama both, an army of angels will come and pray behind you, my brothers and sisters. So this is what we have to do. Make sure you start praying Jama'ah with your families, with your sons and daughters and your wives and your moms and dads, everybody in homes. Please, please refrain from any social gathering. Masjid was not a place of social gatherings. It was a place of spiritual retreat. But inshallah, we will now make our homes our masajid, our individual masajid, our qibla, facing the qibla of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is the idea. As I recited before you this last ayah of Surah Yunus, my brothers and sisters. So inshallah, I will be doing another live broadcast like we did before. And we will talk more about it, like what should we do now. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep our iman strong, forgive our shortcomings. If there is anything we have done as a community that displeased Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, may Allah forgive all of us, inshallah ta'ala, and allow us to be back in His home again, inshallah ta'ala. Wallahu alam.